Bless you, everyone, all of our viewers. If you're in your homes, hospitals, prisons, wherever you are, and you're watching us today, we want to declare blessing over your life. Today is a powerful session that we're going to have today. I'm Reverend Pablo David Fonseca, and I'm here to bring you a word that will not return back void. And it is an awesome and always an honor and a pleasure to be able to share the word of God with you. Everyone in the world is crying out for help. Everyone in the world is crying out for more. We need more of Jesus. Even people who do not believe, their souls deep within, they're crying out for help. And today we want to dedicate this session for all those who need help, all those who need a word of hope, all those who need to feel encouraged, all those people who need to wake up. Because we're living in a time that we need more of God and less of us. Because if we have more of God, we have freedom, we have healing, we have deliverance. We have all the resources needed in order to be able to reach our number one goal, salvation. So I would like for you to come with me to the book of 2 Timothy chapter 4. We're going to read from verses 2 to 5. And I want you to soak this into your spirit because we want to come out for you today. You who might not know who Jesus is, maybe you've never heard of a Jesus, maybe you did hear about Jesus, but then, you know, you were hurt or whatever the situation might have been that you were led away. We want to bring you back this good news that Jesus Christ still loves you. I want you to come with me to 2 Timothy chapter 4. We're going to read from verses 2, and I'm going to start reading. It says this, preach the word. That's a primary thing that we must do. Look what it says. Preach the word. Be instant, in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. I want you to have that word, those words, you know, recorded in your heart and in your mind, itching ears. The time will come that they will have their own lust. They will heap to themselves teacher having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of the evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. Today I want to emphasize and detail and strong detail the importance of the evangelistic ministry within the fivefold ministry. You know, in Ephesians 4:11, you know, God appointed some pastors, prophets, apostles, teachers, and evangelists within the fivefold ministry. But today I want to reveal the importance of the evangelistic ministry within the fivefold ministry. And it is an honor for me to present the guest that we're going to have today. I know he has a powerful word for you. Just prepare your hearts, prepare your spirit, prepare your mind for everything that God has for you today. You know, tell your flesh to be quiet and just open up your spirit to receive correction and to receive the truth. The truth shall make us free. And it is an honor for me to present my good friend and brother in Christ, Pastor Juan Canela. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Evangelist. Thank you for inviting me. It's a privilege to be here.
Honor is mine.
To be part of what God is doing here in this ministry, in your life, in your ministry, as well as those who are listening right now, right where you're at. Thank you for inviting me.
Amen. It is an honor. Pastor Juan, I know that you are a pastor. You have a church here in Orlando. It's Light in the Nations International Ministries. Yeah. And I know God has used you powerfully in the church and in the ministry. But before you were a pastor, you were also an evangelist. So we have the same language. You know, I know God has blessed you around the world. You've been to many places and you have been a blessing, you know. And, you know, we think the same. We feel the same. We know what we're about. I'm the type of person that I can go to a crusade. I can go to, you know, to places and preach to thousands of people. There can be healings. There can be signs. There can be wonders. But if there's not a salvation, if there's not salvation of souls, it's like I'm wasting my time. You know, because we want to expand the kingdom. We want to bring expansion in the kingdom. And that is only through the salvation of the lost souls or the reconciliation. We have been giving to us the ministry of reconciliation. What can you tell me about that?
Well, by the grace of God, I've been able to understand. In my first walk in Christ, I was able to understand that we were created to be used by God.
Yes.
And God being invisible, he created us so that his indwelling would be inside of us.
Yes.
Therefore, that we may be a vessel that he may use. And I remember my first, the beginning of my conversion. I remember that me not yet knowing how to flow in that spirit, but I still had the urge and the passion to be used by God so that people could experience what I experienced, so they could have that life that I have. And ever since then, I would say, and I thank God that he gave me understanding as soon as I converted, that part of my responsibility is just like by grace I receive, by grace I also shall give.
Yes.
And I just thank God from the beginning that is something that I had a passion in my conversion, in the experience I had, in the place that I had testified, giving you my testimony where I've been. And it's just always in appreciation, in love for God and appreciation. There's something, and also that passion and that love of God inside me have moved me always to having that passion for people to experience what I experienced, for people to know what I know, have what I have, and also being that we're called not only to conversion, but also to be for servanthood, for that people to also know their purpose, know their destiny, and be part of what God is doing this time. I can tell you, evangelist, that, and in my experience in this time, I'm saying that in God's agenda, his priority is the conversion of souls.
Pastor Wakanela, I believe you're speaking, the truth. I mean, Jesus came to earth, you know, to heal, to deliver, to do so many things, but one of the primary focuses is to die for humanity. He died for the bad, he died for the good. He died so that one day we wouldn't have to pay the consequences, so that one day, you know, we can just accept them to our lives and receive eternal salvation. I believe salvation doesn't begin in heaven. Salvation begins as soon as we receive Jesus in our hearts and in our lives.
Amen.
You know, so, you know, once we receive that salvation, we have to walk according to that salvation. But why, you know I have so many, you know, perspectives, so many things, you know, to think about, my opinions. But in your perspective, why do you think people are such resistant to good news?
I would say because this time,
too many negative.
A lot. And what one of the means that the kingdom of darkness is using, unfortunately, is the media. I thank God that he's given the church, this body, the wisdom, understanding to be able to use technology, use the media. But unfortunately, we're in a generation that people are not converting as it was 20, 30 years ago. And I say because, unfortunately, Satan has been looking forward to having territory in their mind, in their souls, through many other factors. But one of the big ones right now is media. And negativity, off of focus, you know, what's going on in this time. And it's just keeping people off of focus. And another smoke that he tries to put, especially into believers, is not understanding purpose, not understanding destiny, not understanding the invitation of God in their life for a calling to participate in this plan of what God is doing here. But generally, mainly to for salvation, preaching that word. And many people, another aspect or another part also, people has been familiarized with the terminology. And number three, also people have had the wrong concept and aspect when it comes to church, when it comes to God, wrong understanding, lies of Satan.
Wrong
and this where we come to bring in the truth. The truth shall set them free.
Yes.
But that is our responsibility, to take the responsibility, attend the command of us preaching the gospel so that people may convert. And it is not in our own strength that we should comfort in or that we should feel confident in. It's in the Spirit of God.
Yes.
His grace upon those people who don't know Christ, but his grace upon them, that he may do that divine connection in the moment, that he may bring those people, the right people, right in the moment. He will do that. That is the God, that's the omnipotent God that I know, omniscient. He has that sovereignty of how to coordinate somebody right in the spot, that he may use us to simply preach the gospel of the kingdom. The gospel of the kingdom, the word is all they need, not in our strength. And by the grace of God, there is a remnant, people who will, by the grace of God upon their life, when we speak that word, when we share our testimony, when we move in the prophetic, the grace of God is upon their life and they will repent and they will convert. The word of God says that repentance, he's the one that gives the repentance. He's the one that gives the grace.
Yes.
In due season, in moment, there is people who do convert.
Yes, I believe it is. There's a power, you said the power of testimony. There is a powerful power within the testimony that we have. You know, who we were before we met Christ and now that we have met Christ, you know? So I believe that, you know, we don't have to be so knowledgeable of the world, even though knowing the word and memorizing scripture is extremely important to me personally. It's very, very important. But, you know, the power of testimony, something that God has done in your life, it is extremely powerful because no one can pretty much argue with you. It's something that God did for you.
Yeah.
You know, the word is like, oh, yeah. You know, a lot of people say, yeah. I don't know what people have told me. A lot of people have told me so many things while evangelizing. Yeah, the Bible was inspired by men, you know, whatnot. But, you know, it's word of God. Mm-hmm. God tells the writer to write, you know, so it's the word of God, you know. So, but the power of a testimony is that, you know, it's something that has happened to you. So, but right before we come back to our session, we're going to go on a quick break. But before we go on a quick break, I want to let you know that we're going to be speaking about what is the main cause of being resistant to good news. I want you to stay tuned. We're going to go to a short break and we will be back in a few seconds.
God's Country, 7 keys for you to live an extraordinary life by rediscovering your identity, nationality, and purpose. A kingdom book that every leader, minister, and church should have. Pablo speaks about topics and leaves a clear revelation on how the kingdom of heaven functions. He explains the difference between Jesus and religion, a Pharisaical mindset, and a kingdom mindset, how kingdom leaders function as God's representatives. He explains the heart and the character of a true leader and how authority can only be received under submission. A kingdom book brought to your life so that you can receive breakthroughs, accelerations, and knowledge. You can obtain your copy at www.trueperspectivepublishing.com or globally everywhere books are sold. Change your mindset to a kingdom mindset today.
Welcome back from the break, and I know you enjoyed the commercials. I know that God has been speaking to your spirit, speaking to your mind, and I know that God is going to reveal certain strategies to teach our churches to how to win souls. You know that, you know, the Bible says in Luke chapter 14, verse 21, Luke 14, 21, it says clearly, you know, go to the highways and to the hedges and force them to come in so that my house may be filled. So what happens, you know, a church growth has to deal with evangelism. A church that evangelizes is a church that will grow. And I know that there's certain strategies that Pastor Juan Canela teaches, you know, for us to have successful evangelism, especially in our young generation, Pastor Juan. A lot of our young people are resistant. Teach us and show to the people that are watching us, how can we strategize to reach this tough crowd?
Well, evangelist, one thing I've had, and I've had from experience and also by revelation, is that there are some key elements to fulfillment of the Great Commission. The Great Commission is something that Jesus gave to all. He says in Matthew 28, he says, all authority has been given unto him. So therefore, because all authority he had gained, and he said, therefore, go, preach the gospel. And also make disciples, teaching them the same thing that I've commanded you. And that is the responsibility of every believer, being used by the Holy Spirit, being used by the Spirit of God in order to win souls in the moment. And I've also been able to understand that we solely have to depend on the grace of God. The Holy Spirit is what comes upon the person, unbeliever, by grace, that unbeliever will understand when you start speaking. Mm-hmm. In the moment, just simply using the Word of God, being obedient and yielding to the Holy Spirit in the moment, on the now, in the moment, the person will convert. I've come to understand this, and I teach many churches, is that you have to depend on the move of the Spirit. Yes. Number one, you have to be obedient to the Holy Spirit of God. You have to be obedient to the move of the Spirit, because there's many ways how the Holy Spirit would want to move.
So we have to have that discernment.
Of course. Obedience and yielding. For that, it demands a relationship with God.
Yes, sir.
You have to have a relationship with God. So therefore, believing God in obedience and also yielding to the Spirit. Number two, Jesus spoke about Luke chapter 9, 1 and 2. He says, then he called his disciples together and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure disease. Verse 2 says, he sent them to preach the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. That is number two key element, very important in the Great Commission. To obtain result when you have an unbeliever in front of you.
Yes.
And it's solely depending on the power and the authority that Jesus has delegated to us for us to fulfill the Great Commission.
Yes.
See, God is invisible, but he depends on us. And as I said earlier, as soon as I converted, I knew I had a calling. I understood just by love and appreciation. I said, Lord, I will love. I started loving mankind. I started loving humanity. And that's key number four, love and compassion. And compassion, so I started having love and compassion. I would tell you, anybody who want to be a soul winner, you need compassion. You need that love of Christ. That's what moved Jesus to do what he did. That's what moved Jesus at all times to present the gospel. Yes. That's what moved to speak his word, to minister, heal, and deliver is love and compassion. And also, number three, grace and favor. The grace and favor is one of the keys elements that we depend on.
Yes.
We need the grace and favor of God. Without the grace and favor, I'll be doing it in my own flesh. And that's when Satan will come in and make you feel, well, you're not an evangelist. You may not have the gift. Or you know what?
You're not good enough.
Hey, who's going to listen to you? Your testimony? What about your testimony? You ain't got no testimony. That's a lie straight from the pits of hell. Yeah. And I'll tell you, our testimony, one of what has brought us to have effect in an unbeliever's life is our testimony, who we were before Christ.
Yes.
What was the outcome when we were walking without Christ? What had happened to us? How was our life before we knew Christ? And number three, how did I get to know Christ? How did that encounter happen in a moment? And number four, what has been the outcome after knowing Christ? And no matter how simple you may see your testimony be, God in his sovereignty, he'll coordinate. He'll put the right people in your path and he will use you because it's his agenda.
Yes.
Is his coordinate, is a divine connection in the moment. He'll give you the grace. He'll give you the favor. All he needs is for you to be obedient.
Available.
Yielding to the Spirit for you to believe and trust that he has given you power and authority and love and compassion. Without that, we ain't having much.
You know, with the love and compassion, I believe that is very, very important. And one thing that love and compassion comes in for souls, we have to ask for it. We have to ask God for that love to invade our hearts the same, because love and compassion is what provoked God to send his son for humanity. Amen. He had love. He had compassion for the souls, you know, and one thing we have to do when we're evangelizing is not to compare ourselves to anyone. We are all open to receive salvation. God loves us all the same. There is no favoritism in God, you know, and just as you were able to receive the gift of salvation, whoever it is that does not have it today has that same right, only if he or she accept that same offer that God has to offer us through his son, Jesus. You receive him in your heart. You know, no one here is better than anyone. You know, if we receive Jesus, you could have been a drug dealer. You could have been a prostitute. You could have been a disobedient child. You could have been, you know, whatever it is that you were, a killer, whatever it is that you could be. If you receive Jesus in your heart, you know, and people might be asking you, a killer? Yeah, Apostle Paul, before he was Paul, he was Saul. He used to persecute and kill the Christians.
Yes.
You know, he had that encounter with Jesus, you know? So it's not about your past. It's about how you overcame it.
Yeah.
You know, how that love and that compassion reached your life. And just the same way that God's love and compassion has reached your life, his love and compassion can reach others through you.
Exactly. And I would say that's one of the factors, one of the key factors, unfortunately, or creates a stronghold that many, many even believers don't flow in the Spirit, and it's because of their past.
Yeah.
There's many people that go out to evangelize, and Satan in the moment will put in their mind how at one time they mocked the church or the believers, and then they start feeling inferior, or they think that the person they're going to approach, the person gonna think that they're a fanatic.
Yes.
But those are strongholds. That's a lie straight from the pit of hell.
Yeah.
And that is not true. And evangelize, I want to take the opportunity. We're going to be praying for people also, those who are listening right now, so you could receive Christ the Lord and Savior. But we're also going to be praying for people also to learn how to move in the Spirit,
in
the flow of the Spirit, for what God wants to do with the non-believer in the moment.
Yes.
When I go out to evangelize, or I train churches that when they go out to evangelize, to understand that in reality it's between God and the non-believer. We're just a vessel willing and being able and willing to be used and moved. So therefore, one of the key elements, I would say, or the principles to getting results, number one, I would say, is moving in the power of the word.
Yes.
Understanding that when you go out to evangelize, you don't have to talk much. You don't have to talk a lot. All you have to do is preach the word, the kingdom. That's what the word of God says. Preach the gospel of the kingdom of God and preach repentance. Call them into repentance. Simple. The Holy Spirit will use you in the moment. But I've understood and I've had from experience also. And we train churches to move in the prophetic. Because God will move you in the moment and will show you a word of wisdom,
yes,
word of knowledge, God will show you in the moment something that will impact that person to understand that God is present. God is in the mix. You don't know the person, but God is showing you something about the person, and that's very important. That is dormant nowadays in a lot of churches. The evangelistic ministry is dormant in a lot of churches, but what God is moving right now is in the prophetic. And number three, your testimony.
Yes.
That has to be also a key element that the Holy Spirit will use. All you have to do is be obedient and yield to it.
Pray for them.
Amen.
Pastor.
I would like to take the opportunity right now, and I want to pray for you. Those who are listening right now, I just wanted to tell you from my experience, I thank God that he reached me and that I had a personal encounter, and that's all that I got to ask. So if you're willing right now to receive Christ as Lord and Savior, I will tell you the word of God says that there is a heaven and a hell. God's passion right now is for you to be in heaven, for you to go to heaven. God's passion is for your soul to be in his presence at all time. Be one in him. So if you want to receive Christ as Lord and Savior, I want to pray for you right now. I want you to bow your hand. I want you to repeat after me, and I want you to say, Father God, I thank you for this opportunity.
Yes, Lord.
I recognize that I'm a sinner and that my sins have separated me from you. And I make a decision right now to repent, and I ask for forgiveness. And by faith, I confess, yes, Jesus, that you're the Son of God and that you died on the cross for me. Repeat after me. Thank you, Jesus, that you died for me. Yes. By faith, I believe, and by faith, I receive salvation. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Evangelist, if you give me the opportunity, I also want to pray for those right now who have the passion to win soul, but don't know how to go about it. All you need, the Bible says, for us to equip the saints.
Yes.
As the saints. The Bible says, for us to equip the saints. So therefore, I want to pray for those right now who are listening. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, I pray for those who are listening right now. I pray for those, Father, that you may impart and give and put of that love and compassion that was in Jesus, that passion to go out and believe you and win souls.
Yes,
and I declare,
Father,
in the name of Jesus right now, you that are listening, I declare that the power of God will be upon your life for you to move in power and authority. It's in you. All you have to do is believe.
Yes.
Father, I pray that you may activate that power and that authority in their lives, Father, that they may move in the delegation and what you have given them,
Jesus,
that their eyes may open and understand who they are in you and the identity that you have given them as believers to move in power and also in the authority. Father, I pray, Father, that gifts, that your grace and favor and the gift may activate in their life right now in the name of Jesus. I declare the gift of God to move in the prophetic, gift for you to release word, to move in the prophetic, to move in word of wisdom, word of knowledge right now to win souls. Let the Holy Spirit use you. Father, I thank you. I declare and Father, activate it for your glory and the fulfillment, Father, of your command, Father,
you,
for
Jesus,
us to preach the gospel and win souls for your glory and your kingdom. In Jesus' name, Father, I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Juan. It was an honor to have you here today. Honor to have you. I just want to let you know that we also have this book that I wrote, Gathering the Perfect Harvest. It is a book to disciple you as well, to win souls. We thank you for sharing time with us. We love you guys, and stay tuned until our next program. God bless you.